message today.
Ujumbe wangu wa leo
is this the stone that the builders rejected.
Ni ujumbe kwamba jiwe lililokataliwa na waasi.
But became the cornerstone.
Lakini likaja kuwa jiwe kuu la pembeni.
And that is Jesus Christ.
Na huyo ni Yesu Kristo.
So in the book of Matthew 21 verses 42.
Katika kitabu cha Mathayo 21 mlango mstari wa 42.
Jesus said to them.
Yesu akawaambia.
Have you never read in the scriptures?
Je, hamjasoma maandiko?
The stone the builders rejected.
Kwamba jiwe lililokataliwa na waasi.
Has become the capstone.
Limekuwa jiwe la pembeni.
Oh, the cornerstone.
Ama jiwe kuu la pembeni.
Praise be the name of the living God.
Jina la Bwana litukuzwe.
And the Lord has done this.
Na Bwana ametenda hivi.
It is marvelous in our eyes.
Ni maajabu kwa macho yetu.
Praise be the name of the living God.
Jina la Bwana lipewe sifa.
And the Lord has done this.
Na Bwana ametenda haya.
And it is marvelous in our eyes.
Ni maajabu katika sisi.
What I want to express to you.
Kile nataka kuambia.
Is that dogs building.
Ya kwamba
no firm building.
Hakuna jengo linaweza simama.
Praise be the name of the living God.
Jina la Yesu litukuzwe.
Without the capstone.
Bila jiwe la pembeni.
And without the cornerstone.
Na bila jiwe kuu la pembeni.
The cornerstone.
Jiwe la pembeni.
Is the one that aligns a building.
Ndio lile linalolainisha jumba.
To make a building be firm.
Linafanya jumba
liwe. And also make a building be properly built.
Linafanya jiwe liwe kuu na liwe tena
limejengwa vizuri. And the cornerstone.
Na jiwe la pembeni.
Is a stone that starts down from the before the building goes up.
Ni jiwe linaloanza msingi.
Because that's the cornerstone.
Kwa sababu hiyo jiwe la pembeni.
One that gives the structure alignment.
Jolile napeana jumba kuwa na mjengo mwema.
Praise be the name of the living God.
Jina la Bwana litukuzwe.
That's why the Bible says.
Posa Biblia inasema.
That the Bible says very clearly.
Biblia inasema wazi.
The stone that the builders rejected.
Kwamba jiwe lililokataliwa na waasi.
I want you to look at this word, the stone.
Nataka uangalie jambo hili.
That the builders rejected.
Ambalo wajenzi walikataa.
They didn't reject Jesus.
Hawakukataa Yesu.
They rejected the stone.
Walikataa jiwe.
But the stone is Jesus.
Lakini jiwe ni Yesu.
That they rejected.
Ambalo walikataa.
Are you understanding me?
Je, mnaelewa mimi?
Are you understanding me?
Mnanielewa?
Are you understanding me?
Mnanielewa?
So Jesus came with that prophet that parable.
Kwa hivyo Yesu akaja na neno hili.
And gave them this word, the stone.
Na akawaambia neno hili jiwe.
And let me tell you.
Na wacha niwaambie.
Jesus is the stone.
Yesu ndilo jiwe.
But he didn't tell them I was rejected.
Lakini hakuambia mimi Yesu nilikataliwa.
But he said the stone.
Lakini akasema
jiwe. That was rejected by the builders.
Ambalo likataliwa na waasi.
That stone became the capstone.
Lile jiwe likawa jiwe la pembeni.
He knew what he was talking about.
Alijua kila alikuwa ananena.
But if you read the scripture properly.
Ukisoma maandiko vizuri.
Jesus Christ was rejected.
Kwamba Yesu ndiye alikataliwa.
Praise be the name of the living God.
Jina la Bwana litukuzwe.
And that's why he was crucified.
Na ndipo akasulubiwa.
If you read the Bible very well.
Ukisoma Biblia vizuri.
When Jesus was taken to the Pilate.
Wakati Yesu alichukuliwa kwa Pilato.
The Bible says.
Andiko yanasema.
That there was a man, a thief, who was there.
Palikuwa na mwizi pale.
Called Barabbas.
Barabbas. Aliyeitwa Barabbas.
So they asked, who between these two, who do you think we should crucify.
Wakaulizwa kati ya hawa wawili tumsulubishe nani?
Jesus.
Wakasema Yesu.
The Pilate said this man is innocent.
Pilato akasema huyu mtu hana hatia.
And they said kill him. We have said crucify.
Wakasema muue tumesema.
This man makes himself the king of kings.
Huyu mtu anajifanya mfalme wa falme.
So kill him.
Kwa hivyo muue.
They left a thief.
Wakamwachilia mwizi.
But it was good.
Lakini ilikuwa ni vizuri.
Because we could have not been who we are today.
Hatungekuwa vile tulivyo leo.
Jesus accepted to be crucified.
Kama Yesu angekubali kusulubiwa.
And now because Jesus became the capstone.
Na kwa sababu Yesu alifanyika jiwe la pembeni.
He is the capstone.
Na yeye ni jiwe la pembeni.
Then through him is what we are today.
Kwamba kupitia yeye ndio vile tulivyo leo.
Now we say that we are born again.
Kwa hivyo tunasema tumezaliwa mara ya pili.
Christians.
Kama wa Kristo.
But without the cornerstone.
Lakini bila jiwe la pembeni.
No, not be Christians.
Hatuwezi kuwa wa Kristo.
Praise be the name of the living God.
Jina la Bwana.
But I want to teach you this way.
Nataka kuwafundisha hivi.
That no structure.
Ya kwamba hakuna mjengo.
Like this one.
Kama huu.
Could be the way it is.
Ambao unaweza kuwa vile ulivyo.
Without a cornerstone.
Bila jiwe la pembeni.
A cornerstone is what aligns a structure.
Jiwe la pembeni ndilo linaloanisha msingi.
Let me tell you.
Na wacha niwaambie.
If you go to where people are constructing.
Ukienda mahali mjengo unafanyika.
They reject structure. stones. They pick this stone. The masons pick this stone. And they try to put it to align that house. And then they try to align with that stone. But they see this stone cannot do it. Cannot align. Cannot make the foundation to be proper. Cannot make the building to be straight. They throw it away. They bring another one. They try to align it. They see it cannot work. They reject it. They bring another one. They try. It does not work. They reject it. But a time comes. When the time comes. When they have tried all. They say no. Let's go back to those ones we rejected. We shall try and get one from there. Praise be the name of the living God. We rejected all these stones. But I think we can find a cornerstone from there. Praise be the name of the living God. And they walk again. The masons walk again there. Then they try to get one stone. Or four stones. So that they can make the cornerstone. So they pick again. And they say, let's try this one. And they say, this one now is fit to be the cornerstone. But they had rejected it. Praise be the name of the living God. So I want to talk about two topics. Praise be the name of the living God. I want to talk about rejection. Praise be the name of the living God. You can be rejected, and we have been living in the life of rejection because of the Christ you are carrying in our hearts. Praise be the name of the living God. God. Praise be the name of the living God. You are rejected because of the Christ you are carrying in you. But I want to tell you one thing. May you stand firm. Because you cannot carry Christ, who is a cornerstone, and you also don't become a cornerstone. And that's what the Bible says. We are the salt of the earth. We are the light of the earth. Because we bear the name of the Lord Jesus, who became the capstone. Praise be the name of the living God. Because we bear the name of the living God, we bear the name of Christ. Through Christ we are who we are today. And the Bible says very clearly in 1 John 4:4 that the one in me is greater than the one in the world. So if Christ is in me, he is greater than the one in the world. So he says God has also elevated you. Praise be the name of the living God. 1 John 4:4. The one in me, the cornerstone in me, has also made me a cornerstone. Praise be the name of the living God. So you are not an ordinary person, because the one in you is Christ Jesus, who has also made you a cornerstone. Oh my God, you are a cornerstone. Praise be the name of the living God. You are not just an ordinary person, because the one in you is greater than the one in the world, and he has made you a cornerstone. Praise be in the name of living God. So the cornerstone is what aligns a structure. So God makes you a cornerstone because you bear the name of the living God, you bear the name of Jesus Christ, so that many people depend on you and you align their lives and you guide them and you lead them. They depend on you because you are a cornerstone. Praise be the name of the living God. Even your family members will depend on you because you have become a capstone. Praise be the name of the living God. Because the one in you, he is the capstone. And so you become a capstone. Praise be the name of the living God. And that's why the Bible says, the Bible says like this, and the Lord has done this, and it is marvelous in our eyes. My friend, Let me teach you today. You are marvelous in the eyes of the people of the world. Praise be the name of the living God. You are just not an ordinary person. You are not an ordinary singer. You are not an ordinary preacher. My friend, you are marvelous before the eyes of the world. Praise be the name of the living God. Because the one in you has made you a cornerstone. You are attractive to many because you are a cornerstone. Praise be the name of the living God. God has elevated you. Has made you very important. That's why he's in you. God cannot dwell in somebody who is not important. Jesus cannot be in you if you are not important. That's why he chose you and he called you. And he set you aside. Praise be the name of the living God. So this stone was rejected. Rejection is a ladder. Rejection is a ladder. To make you be strong and dependable on and how do you say dependable to many people. Rejection is a ladder. If Jesus was not rejected, then he could have
no
value. You are rejected because you have value. You are rejected because you bear the name of the living God. And since you carry that bear that name of Lord Jesus, the name that's above other names, then you are very important person. You are a person of value. You are a capstone. So the rejection sometimes you undergo, do not cry. Do not complain. You bear the name of Jesus. Sometimes people reject you.
Mara nyingine watu hukukataa.
And not even sometimes, many times.
Mara mingi.
Even our family members reject us.
Hata watu wa jamii hukukataa.
But at the end of everything,
lakini mwisho wa kila jambo,
they come and say, ah,
wanakuja wanasema,
my brother, he was very important person.
Ndugu yangu alikuwa mtu wa thamani.
We didn't know he was very important.
Hatukujua ni mtu wa thamani.
My brother, come and pray for us.
Ndugu yangu njoo utuombe.
Lay your hands upon us.
Weka mikono
yako.
My
sister, come and pray for us.
Ndugu yetu kuja utuombe.
We didn't know that she has value.
Hatukujua wewe ni wa thamani.
We thought maybe she's just an ordinary person.
Tulijua labda ni mtu wa kawaida tu.
We have been ignoring her because she says she's saved.
Tumekuwa tukimkataa maana anasema ameokolewa.
They reject you because you bear the name of Jesus Christ.
Wanakukataa kwa sababu unabeba jina la Yesu Kristo.
You are born again.
You are saved. Mara ya pili, umeokolewa.
What is salvation? What is salvation?
Wokovu ni nini?
A savior, a person who makes himself a savior has come.
Mtu ambaye amebeba wokovu anasema amekuja.
Let's move on this side.
Wacha tusonge pande hii.
Family members even they move on at a corner.
Watu wa jamii pia wanaenda katika
kona
nini?
They reject you.
Wanakukataa.
They start talking their issues.
Wanaanza kuongea mambo yao.
She'll just come here and start talking about Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Anakuja hapa anaanza kuongea mambo ya Yesu, Yesu.
Salvation, are you saved or you are this?
Wokovu,
they reject you.
Unasema wanakukataa.
Stand firm.
Simama imara.
Stand firm.
Simama imara.
Do not be shaken.
Usitingizwe.
You bear the name of the Lord.
Unabeba jina la Yesu.
And since you bear that name,
na kwa vile unabeba jina hilo,
you are a cornerstone in that family.
Wewe ni jiwe katika
hiyo. They depend on you.
Wanakutegemea.
You will align them.
Wewe unawalainisha.
You will align them.
Utawalainisha.
Because you bear the name of the living God.
Kwa sababu unabeba jina la Mungu aishie.
He must make sure.
Lazima hakikishe.
They come and depend on you.
Wanakuja na kuinama mbele zako.
And let me tell you.
Na wacha nikuambie.
Even somebody called Joseph was rejected.
Hata mtu aitwa Yusufu alikataliwa.
And even sold.
Na hata akauzwa.
You might have been rejected and sold.
Anaweza kuwa alikataliwa.
You might have been rejected and sold.
Unaweza kuwa umekataliwa na kuuzwa.
Stand firm.
Simama imara.
Stand firm.
Simama imara.
The Bible says.
Biblia inasema.
He was rejected.
Alikataliwa.
They sold him.
Wakamuuza.
To a foreign country.
Katika inchi ya ugenini.
He went to the foreign country.
Akaenda katika inchi ya ugenini.
And he stayed there.
Na akaishi pale.
I don't want to talk about the whole history.
Na tuwezi ongea historia yote.
But he became in charge.
Lakini akawa mtu ambaye anasimamia.
In charge.
Msimamizi.
In charge.
Msimamizi.
in charge
msimamizi
of the whole of Egypt
katika inchi ya Misri
and the people who rejected him
waliomkataa
they came
wakaja
the time of need
wakakuja wakati wanahitaji wakati wa kuhitaji
they came
wakaja
and they looked at him
wakamwangalia
but he looked at them
na akawaangalia
he knew these are the people who rejected me
na akajua hawa ndio walionikataa
the Lord has had made him marvelous
Mungu alikuwa amemtengeneza mtu wa ajabu
they didn't even know him
hawakumjua
they'll not even know you
hawatakujua
when the Lord is going to make you marvelous
wakati Mungu atakunda
watu people have rejected you
wale watu wamekukataa
they'll not even know you
hawatakujua
when the Lord makes you marvelous
wakati Mungu atakufanya wacha
they'll look at you
watakuangalia
and look at those people who are looking at looking for help from Joseph
angalia wale watu ambao wanatafuta usaidizi kutoka kwa Yusuf
they were his blood brothers
ni watu wa damu moja
and they didn't even know him
na wakumjua
because he was marvelous
kwa sababu alikuwa wacha
in the eyes of the people who rejected him
katika macho ya waliomkataa alikuwa wacha
in the eyes of the world
kwa dunia
he was marvelous
alikuwa wachabu
and they looked at him
na wakamwangalia
and they didn't even know he was their brother
na wakujua kwamba alikuwa ni ndugu yao
the brother they rejected
ule ndugu yao waliomkataa
he looked at them like this
akawaangalia hivi
and he said these are my brothers
akasema hawa ni ndugu zangu
these are my family
hii ni jamii yangu
rejected me
walinikataa
can you put them aside
akaweka kando
put them aside
waweke kando
and when he was giving out food stuff
wakati alikuwa anapeana chakula
so keep them aside
akasema waweke kando
I'll deal with them
nitashughulika nao
and then they thought they are so special
wakafikiria ni wa thamani sana
but they didn't know this is a man that we sold
hawakujua kwamba huyu ni yule waliyemuuza
marvelous before the eyes of God
bali alikuwa mzuri
and so he didn't want to repay back
na hakutaka kulipiza
evil
yale mabaya
set them aside
akasema waweke pembeni
I'll bless them abundantly
nitawabariki kwa wingi
they carried food
wakabeba
chakula you know you're a capstone
wewe ni chuo la pembeni
you know you're a capstone
wewe ni chuo la pembeni
even though they reject you
hata kama wanakukataa
even whoever rejects you
ule yote
may you stand firm
simama imara
because one time
sababu wakati mmoja
they'll come before you
watakuja mbele zako
and they see the wonders of God
na wataona miujiza ya Mungu
the Lord has done in your life
wana ile Mungu ametenda
maisha praise the name of the living God
ila Bwana litukuzwe
and you will become
na wewe utakuja
marvelous before their eyes
mtu ajabu katika
maisha they'll not realize you
hawatagundua
they'll not even know this is my sister
hawatajua kwamba huyu dada yangu
they'll not even know this is my brother
hawatajua kwamba huyu ndugu yangu
but when they come closer
lakini wakija karibu
yeah he looks like our brother
anaangalia kama ndugu yetu anafanana ndugu yetu
but you know we had ignored this man
lakini tulikuwa tumemkataa
but the way God has lifted this man
lakini vile Mungu amemuinua
so marvelous
yeye ni wa ajabu
my sister is so marvelous
dada yangu ni wa ajabu
now today we have come to see her
sasa leo tumekuja kumuona
and you because you be marvelous
na kwa sababu utakuwa wa ajabu
with the heart of God
na katika moyo wa Bwana
tell them relax
unawaambia tulieni
eat food whatever food you want
leni chakula
and that car
hiyo gari
will take you back home
itakurudisha nyumbani
marvelous
maajabu
marvelous
maajabu
before the eyes of the people who rejected you
kwa macho ya wale waliokukataa
and I'm telling you today
na nakwambia leo
you are a cornerstone
wewe ni jiwe la pembeni
you stand knowing that through Christ Jesus
wewe simama
has made you a cornerstone
amekufanya
that's why he says you are the light of the earth
wewe ni mwanga
wa salt of the earth
na chumvi ya dunia
without you
bila wewe
people rejected you
waliokukataa
they have no taste
hawatakuwa na ladha
you'll be the test
wewe ndio utakuwa na ladha
in the midst of that family of yours
katika ukati wa jamii yako
we walk in and they say this is salt has come
natembea ndani wanasema chumvi imekuja
this is a believer this is a born again person has come
ina nasema muumini amekuja
but when you come in there
lakini ukija pale
they reject a stone
that
Jesus has made a capstone
limetengenezwa jiwe la pembeni
na before the eyes
mtu ajabu
rejected you
wale watu waliokukataa
they say oh my
watasema oh
this is God
huyu ni Mungu
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 our sister was so thin saying that she's fasting and praying
dada yetu alikuwa amekonda akisema anafunga na akiomba
and we thought that Jesus God has rejected her
na tukafikiria Mungu amemkataa
salvation had no value
wokovu hauna thamani
today we have come to realize
sasa wamekuja kugundua
the salvation of Christ has value
kwamba wokovu wa Yesu una thamani
our sister can you pray for us
dada yetu unaweza kutuombea
and me I want to emulate you
na mimi nataka nifanye kama wewe
I want to emulate you
nataka kufanya kama wewe
I want to be like you my sister
nataka niwe kama wewe
I want to be like you my brother
nataka niwe kama wewe ndugu yangu
I thought you are taking a wrong direction
nilifikiria ulichukua
mwelekeo I've come to realize you took the rightful direction
ulichukua njia nzuri
and now pray for our family
sasa ombea jamii yetu
pray for our family
ombea jamii yetu
You are the only one we will depend upon.
Wewe tu ndio tunakutegemea.
We know your prayer God will hear.
Tunajua maombi yako
Bwana atasikia. Prayers God will not hear. But your prayers today, my sister, God will hear. The rejected stone became the capstone and saved all the world. So today, I want to make it to be strong. Be strong. The story of Jesus.
Historia ya Yesu.
This Matthew talked about it.
Matayo aliongelea.
And also Luke talked about it.
Hata Luka akaongelea.
Luke talked about it in the book of Luke 20 verses 17.
Luka akaongelea katika
kitabu. He talked the same thing.
Luka 20 mstari wa 17.
The stone that was rejected.
Akasema jiwe lililokataliwa.
Luke saw about it.
Luka aliona.
And let me teach you another thing.
Na wacha niwafunze kitu.
That you may not even know and understand.
Ya kwamba hamngeelewa
ama. Even the psalmist talked about it.
Hata Zaburi iliongelea.
Psalms 119 verses 22 to 23.
Zaburi 119 22 hadi 23.
Luke 20:17.
Luka 20:17.
And Psalms 118 verses 22 to 23.
Na Zaburi 118 21 22.
The stone that was rejected.
Jiwe lililokataliwa.
Became the capstone.
Lilikuja jiwe lilikuwa jiwe la pembeni.
Praise be the name of the living God.
Jina la Bwana litukuzwe.
So even David the psalmist.
Hata Daudi mwenye zaburi.
In the Old Testament.
Katika agano la kale.
This revelation came to him.
Ufunuo huu ulikuja kwake.
That there's a time that is coming.
Ya kwamba kuna wakati unakuja.
There's a stone that builders will reject.
Kuna jiwe waasi watalikataa.
And in the book of Psalms 118 verses 22 and 23.
Katika maandiko Zaburi 118
22. The Bible says clearly.
Maandiko yanasema hivi.
The stone the builders rejected.
Jiwe waasi walilikataa.
Has become.
Limekuja.
The Bible says has become.
Maandiko yanasema limekuja.
Has become the capstone.
Limekuja kuwa jiwe la pembeni.
Oh, it sounds so nice when the Bible says has become.
Katika Zaburi 119 maandiko yanasema imekuja.
And the book of Matthew says became.
Na maandiko katika Mathayo yanasema lilikuja.
Became the capstone.
Lilifanyika jiwe la pembeni.
And the psalmist says has come.
Na Daudi anasema limekuja.
To be the capstone.
Kuwa jiwe la pembeni.
Has come.
Limekuja.
Praise be the name of the living God.
Jina la Bwana litukuzwe.
Has become the capstone.
Limefanyika jiwe la pembeni.
And became the capstone.
Na lilifanyika jiwe la
pembeni.
Praise
be the name of the living God.
Jiwe la Bwana litukuzwe.
So I want to encourage you.
Kwa hivyo nataka nikutie
nguvu. This is not a revelation that came through the New Testament.
Sababu huu sio ufunuo ulikuja katika
This revelation started in the Old Testament.
Ufunuo ulianza katika agano la kale.
Praise be the name of the living God.
Jina la Bwana litukuzwe.
That David was revealed this.
Ya kwamba Daudi ali
The psalmist was revealed this.
Kwamba Daudi alipewa ufunuo huu.
And the history of the word of God.
Na historia ya neno la Bwana.
Continues unfolding one after another.
Inaendelea ikikuja ufunuo mwingine kwa mwingine.
That's why Matthew came up with was revealed the same message.
Ndio kwa sababu Mathayo alipewa ufunuo huo.
Then Luke was also revealed the same message.
Na pia Luka akapewa ufunuo huo.
Praise be the name of the living God.
Jina la Bwana litukuzwe.
Because the word of God is a word that the word of God is a word of prophecy.
Kwa sababu jina la neno la Bwana ni neno la unabii.
And the word of prophecy must come to pass.
Na neno la unabii lazima litimie.
It doesn't matter how long.
Haijalishi muda gani.
Praise be the name of the living God.
Jina la Bwana litukuzwe.
Now this story of the New Testament.
Kwa hivyo historia hii ya agano la Jesus. Kuhusu Yesu.
We are talking about 2000 years beyond and beyond.
Tunaongelea miaka 2000 zilizopita na hata.
And now about the Old Testament.
Lakini sasa kwa agano la kale.
Long time.
Ni wakati wa kale.
And the Bible says.
Biblia inasema.
Psalmist was revealed this message.
Daudi alipewa ufunuo.
Then Matthew came and was revealed the same message.
Na pia Mathayo akaja na akapewa.
Then Luke comes in and also revealed the same message.
Na pia Luka anapatikana amepewa ufunuo.
And today we are being revealed the same message.
Na leo pia tunapewa ufunuo huu.
Through the insight of the Holy Spirit.
Lakini katika ndani ya Roho Mtakatifu.
We are now brought into that scene.
Tunaletwa ndani.
We are now brought into the scene.
Tunaletwa katika ile kuona.
Because through Christ Jesus.
Kwa sababu kupitia Yesu Kristo.
We have become the children of the kingdom of God.
Tumefanyika watoto wa Mungu.
Praise be the name of the living God.
Jina la Bwana
litukuzwe. So we share with Christ.
Kwa hivyo tunashiriki na Yesu.
What Christ has.
Kile Yesu anacho.
And how Christ was became to be.
Na vile Yesu alikuja kufanyika.
So we share with Christ.
Kwa hivyo tunashiriki na Yesu.
Praise be the name of the living God.
Jina la Bwana litukuzwe.
That's why I taught you the other day. We pass through trials and temptations. Because Jesus passed through the same. But he took over all of it. Most of it, he took all our infirmities and all our pains. But we should also pass through it to testify that surely I overcame. You cannot say you are an overcomer and you overcome nothing. You must overcome things. You must align up that I battled this and I battled this and I battled this. In my life, I battled this and I overcame. And I battled this and I overcame. Then I'm a conqueror. I'm more than a conqueror. And the Bible says we are more than conquerors. And I'll ask you one question. What have you conquered? When you say we are more than conquerors, everybody says, hallelujah, I'm more than a conqueror.
Now,
list down what you have conquered. David conquered. Disciples of Jesus conquered. Jesus conquered. Disciples of Jesus conquered. King David conquered. Samson conquered. What have you conquered? You must conquer. You must conquer situations. You must conquer. To become a conqueror. And the Bible has elevated us. And the Bible says we are more than conquerors. Not a conqueror, we are more than conquerors. So what am I saying? Being more than a conqueror, you must be a cornerstone. Because the one in you has made you a cornerstone. And let me tell it today. People must depend on you, on advice, spiritual advice, physical advice, and many others, because you're a conqueror. You're a cornerstone. And you'll have to bring many to Christ. You're a way for many to know Christ. The salvation you're talking about is because Jesus became a cornerstone. They rejected him. But he became. They rejected him. But he became. They saw the importance of him becoming the cornerstone. Because he carried salvation. He became the savior. Praise be the name of the living God. He became the healer. He became the restorer. He the one who gives us hope. He delivers us from darkness. Praise be the name of the living God. So you being a cornerstone, you must be an instrument of use in the kingdom of God. Not just to come to church and look at others. Not just to walk wherever you are in your businesses, wherever you are in your office. You must be a cornerstone. You must see some other people getting saved. You must see others getting saved. You must preach Jesus boldness. With boldness. Not with fear. I know some people even go to the hotel. When the food is brought, they are not even ready to pray for it. They just bend down and then he does the head like this. Ugali kwa mdomo like yesterday. Umaomba? Umaomba kimoyo moyo. Umaomba ya kitu gani? Hakuna mahali Biblia imesema omba kimoyo moyo. Iko mahali my brother. Iko mahali Biblia imesema omba kimoyo moyo. If Jesus was not bold,
kama Yesu angekuwa mjasiri,
he could not be the cornerstone.
Hangekuwa jiwe la pembeni.
When the Jews were looking for him,
wakati Wayahudi walikuwa wanamtafuta,
he could have taken the next matatu quickly.
Angepanda gari la karibu zaidi
haraka. And run to Bungoma.
Akifika Bungoma,
he crosses border to Uganda.
Anavuka mpaka Uganda.
But he stood firm, I'm a cornerstone.
Lakini alisimama imara na kusema mimi ni jiwe la pembeni.
I'm paying a price.
Nalipa gharama.
For these people to be reconciled to God again.
Kwa sababu watu kurejeshwa katika ufalme.
And to be delivered the sins to be forgiven.
Na waokolewe na dhambi zao.
If it were you, pastor,
kama ingelikuwa mchungaji,
tungekutia kule kanisa yetu ya South Africa Molesby. Huko bahari unasema next step, are they coming? If they come, niruke Atlantic Ocean, he cross over niende. Again, he stood firm because he knew he's a cornerstone. There are things we should stand firm because we know we are cornerstone.
Kuna vitu lazima tusimame imara kwa sababu tunajua sisi ni jiwe la
pembeni. Even if you're rejected, you stand firm.
Hata kama umekataliwa, simama imara.
Stand firm because you have Christ in you.
Simama imara kwa sababu kuna Yesu ndani yako.
And you should be proud.
Na lazima uwe
mtu. You should enjoy.
Mtu wa kujisikia.
You should rejoice that you have Christ. You should rejoice that you have Christ.
Furahia kwamba unaye Yesu.
The stone that was rejected
jiwe lilio kataliwa
became the capstone.
Ilifanyika jiwe la pembeni.
From today,
kuanzia leo,
may you stand firm on your 2 feet.
Msimame
kwa know that you are not an ordinary person.
Na mjue
the rejections you are passing through,
yale kukataliwa
you bear the name of Jesus Christ.
Unalibeba jina la Yesu.
And that's why you bear the name of Jesus Christ. And it has made you a cornerstone.
Na amewafanya jiwe la pembeni.
So you are going to battle to the end.
Kwa hivyo mnaenda kupigana mpaka mwisho.
Victory.
Na ushindi.
Not defeat.
Msishindwe.
You will not be defeated.
Hautashindwa.
If you know who is in you.
Wakati unajua aliye ndani yako.
You will not be defeated.
Hautashindwa.
Jesus was not defeated.
Yesu hakushindwa.
He defeated the cross.
Alishinda
msalaba. He ashamed the cross.
Aliaibisha
msalaba. And the Bible says
maandiko
yanasema he ashamed the cross.
Yesu
and also ashamed the grave because he rose up from the grave.
Akaibisha kaburi pia na akafufuka kutoka kwenye kaburi.
And again the Bible says he went under to hell.
Pia Biblia inasema akaenda mpaka chini kwenye
the keys from the devil.
Na akaenda akachukua vifunguu katika kule.
And then he says in the book of Matthew 16:19, then he gave you that key.
Anasema katika Mathayo 16 akapeana vifunguo.
Whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven.
Kile unafunga hapa
will be loosed in heaven.
Kile unafungua hapa
chini. He went down and took the key and gave you the keys.
Alienda akachukua kifunguo na akakupea.
Then you're operating like an ordinary woman here.
Unaomba kama mtu ambaye ni mama mzee.
Like an ordinary man here.
Unaomba kama mzee.
When he went to the grave, he overcame the grave.
Wakati alienda kwenye kaburi alishinda kaburi.
When he went down to the grave to hell.
Akaenda mpaka jehanamu.
The gates of Hades.
Katika mlango.
The keys.
Akachukua kifungo.
And he say, my daughter.
Na akasema msichana wangu.
Here is the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind here will be bound in heaven.
Kile unafunga
hapa kinafungwa in heaven.
Kile unafungwa kinafunguliwa.
The keys are in our hands.
So vifungu niko nazo.
Matthew 16:19.
Mathayo 16:19.
Give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven.
Nimekupa vifunguu vya ufalme wa mbinguni.
Give you the keys of the kingdom of the earth.
Hakutupatia vifunguu vya hapa duniani.
He didn't give you the keys of the kingdom of your cube.
Hakutupea vifunguu vya nyumba zetu.
He gave the keys of the kingdom of heaven.
Alipeana vifunguu vya ufalme.
Whatever you bind you will be bound in heaven.
Unafunga
kitu. Whatever you loose you will be loosed in heaven.
Kile unafungua.
So you are a very powerful man. You are a very powerful woman.
Wewe ni mama mwenye.
Praise be the name of the living God.
Jina la Bwana.
You have the keys of the kingdom of heaven.
Uko na vifunguu
vya mbinguni. Because you bear the name of Jesus Christ.
Kwa sababu unalibeba jina la Yesu.
And he's in you.
Na kwa hivyo yako ndani yako.
1 John 4:4, the Bible says the one in me is greater.
Yohana wa kwanza mlango wa 5 mstari
is greater than 1 John 4:4.
Yohana wa kwanza mlango wa 4 mstari wa 4 anasema aliye ndani yangu ni mkuu zaidi ya aliyoko nje.
So you are more than a missile, you are more than atomic bomb.
Kwa hivyo ni zaidi ya silaha.
Whatever kind of
kama atomic bomb.
You are powerful.
Wewe ni mtu wa nguvu.
Blessed be the name of the Lord Jesus.
Jina Bwana litukuzwe.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Jina la Bwana litukuzwe.
You are not just somebody simple.
Wewe sio mtu tu wa hivi hivi.
The one in you is Jesus.
Aliye ndani yako ni Yesu.
So you must walk knowing that I'm a cornerstone.
Kwa hivyo lazima utembee ukijua kwamba wewe ni jiwe la pembeni.
Hallelujah. Don't walk like a village woman.
Usitembee kama mtu wa mtaa.
Somebody who come from the bush.
Mtu ambaye ametoka kwenye kichaka.
You walk knowing walk majestically.
Unatembea ukiwa na ujasiri.
And the one in me is greater.
Na unasema kwamba aliye ndani yangu ni mkuu.
I'll conquer every situation.
Nitashinda kila hali.
Even if they are tough.
Hata kama
ni conquer the cross.
Kama alishinda.
And he conquered the grave.
Na akashinda
kaburi. And he conquered the gates of Hades.
Na akashinda malango
za kuzimu.
Na akatoka.
And again, because I bear his name, he gave me the keys. In Matthew 18:18 and Matthew 16:19, he gave me the keys. I'm a powerful person. I'm holding the keys of the kingdom of heaven. You have not been given the kingdom of the keys of your house. You have been given the keys of the kingdom of heaven.
Haujapewa funguo vya nyumba yako, umepewa funguo vya ufalme wa mbinguni.
That whatever you bind here will be bound in heaven. Whatever you lose, you'll be losing in heaven. Praise be the name of the living God. You are not just an ordinary person. You have the keys of the kingdom of God. So take charge with that key. Align people. Align situations. Align circumstances. Align your life. Yes, with that key. You bear a very powerful key. God bless you. 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 Let's stand up on our 2 feet. Just for 1 minute, just tell the Lord I'm here today. I've come to realize that the one in me is greater than the one in the world. And I bear the name of Jesus. And now, Lord, I know because you became the capstone. And since you're with me, since you're in me, I've also become the capstone. May I be the capstone. Raise up your hands and speak to the Lord for 1 or 2 minutes. Father, we thank you. Father, I give you the praise. Thank you because of the love of you had for us. You have that love for us, oh God. Today you have spoken to our hearts. Now the stone that was rejected by men, it became the capstone. And Lord, you have said in your word that the one in us is greater than the one in the world. And it is you, Lord Jesus. So today we believe the rejections you are passing through, it is because we are the capstones. And shall continue being capstones. And Lord God, we believe that rejection is a ladder to take us higher. Take us to another level. Joseph was rejected. Joseph was rejected. Even with his close family members. Oh my God. They sold him. But the Bible says, you lifted him, Lord God, and became in charge of the entire Egypt. And the dry time came. The drought time came. In Israel. The same people rejected him. They came for help. So I want to believe that, Lord. People have rejected us. One time, they'll come, my Lord, for help. And we shall do it the way Joseph did it. We shall do it in the name of Jesus. Lord, be glorified. Lord, be glorified. Lord, be glorified. Be exalted. Be honored. Because of your word of today, you have encouraged us. You have given us hope. While we are hopeless, you have given us hope. We thank you, Jesus. We give you the praise. We give you the glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray and believe. Amen.
Amen.
Man of war, Lion of Judah, we bow down and worship you, Yahweh, Yahweh. Come and do what only you can do. Mighty man of war, Lion of Judah, we bow down and worship you, Yahweh.